such an amazing day. Of course, the Murloc Pajama Men are back in force. I don't know why I don't have a Murloc Pajama Man suit.
Well, they just came out, so you can get one.
I gotta get one. If only I could find somebody to talk to about it.
Well, guys, don't forget, if you'd like to continue watching the Blizzard social panel, you can find it under the live tab in the Watchbox, just to the right of this window.
Of course, though, now, the man of the hour joining us now is World of Warcraft game director Ian Hazzacostas. Ian, a little bit of stuff to talk about.
Just a little.
Just a little bit. It's one of those years. You know, it's been four years since we've announced an expansion here.
Really? Four years?
The last time we announced an expansion at BlizzCon was Warlords of Draenor in 2013. It's been 4 years since that's happened.
Wow. That is nuts.
Legion was at Gamescom.
You're right. Because I was live tweeting it at home, and holy cow.
That is fantastic.
I didn't think about that.
We talked a little bit with Mike about this, which was you announced a classic server version, which I know there's going to be more news about later, and that's all great. Which, by the way, everybody went crazy with, including me. But also, back to the Horde versus the Alliance. So it feels like it's a real move this year back to the core that was the original World of Warcraft, even in the conflicts that are happening. How was that decision made?
I think in a lot of ways, I think Alex anchored it perfectly. It's Red versus Blue Horde Alliance. Yeah. That is the beating heart of the Warcraft franchise and has been since the start. And even when we've temporarily put those differences into the background to fight against a greater foe, we've always acted on behalf of our faction, and we view the world through a certain lens.
Yeah.
And so I think, to some extent, it was also what was a good successor to Legion.
Yeah.
And you know, we have expansions that fit into different patterns, different molds. There's the supervillain expansion of, all right, big bad's going to destroy the world.
Yeah.
Right.
And we've had a couple of those.
Sure.
And it's hard to get much bigger and badder than Sargeras and the Burning Legion.
Right.
Yeah.
A little hard.
Yeah, and so it felt like, in a lot of ways, the right time to bring these simmering tensions to the foreground.
Yeah.
And we, you know, this is something we've known for a while. We were heading this direction. Some of those seeds were planted way back at the Broken Shore.
Yeah.
You saw,
you know,
Alliance and Horde walked in, effectively holding hands for a little bit. You saw Sylvanas bail out Varian, trying to fight the Legion. Didn't work out so well, did it?
Didn't last so long with the hand-holding of the Horde and the Alliance.
I mean, there's a lot of really cool things that are going on in this expansion, and one of the things I really want to talk about is the thing that's been data mined a lot, which is the allied races.
Yes.
So let's talk a little bit about how that works. I know you guys went into it in the panel, but what was the inspiration behind wanting to do allied races?
So this is something, you know, it's a feature fans have requested for a long time, often called sub-races. Something along those lines. We've always wanted to expand the number of playable races in WoW, and this theme of searching out new allies made it feel like the perfect time to make it happen. And so we're super excited to bring six new ones into the Alliance of the Horde to start with, but as you mentioned in the panel, this system really is a foundation for new ones to come. It's not, you know, something that comes automatically with an expansion, but the big difference is that you have to earn these. You have to play through the story of bringing them into the Alliance or the Horde, and then you get to make one of your own.
Finally, my ping through the story will pay off.
With
new races.
I love it. And also, you guys got some new content ideas that are coming in with the islands and the Warfront.
Yeah, that's really
cool. Let's talk a little bit about that, because it's always good to give people options just outside of story quests and raids dungeons. So tell us a little bit about islands and about Warfronts.
Yeah, exactly. I think we have, you know, those mainstays of dungeon raid that are ever present. I think in both of these cases, we're looking for ways to tell the story of war in a way that's not just PvP. PvP is there, but it's small-scale skirmish, this vibe of exploration, setting sail, scouting out uncharted territories for any advantage you can gain in the war. And we're revisiting three-player role-agnostic gameplay. You can grab just a couple of friends. Or if you're looking to queue up, because it doesn't matter whether you have, you know, a tank or no tank or 3 DPS, queues will be quick. And as I mentioned in the panel, we really want to build upon so many of the lessons that we've learned making this type of content over the years.
Yeah, I was going to say, I really enjoyed content like this in the past that you guys have done very similar. But this seems like it's just an evolution of what you've done, and it seems like it's better.
replayability, dynamic content, that's the name of the game here. Really capturing that vibe of exploration, so you never quite know what you're going to find when you go there. And then back on the Warfront side, this is just large-scale war. It's, you know, you joining a raid group, basically, but you're not fighting a boss, you're fighting an army.
And this is like Warcraft 3 hero-inspired, where you get like 20 of your friends.
Totally.
And you build it like an RTS, except for it's,
You're in there. You know,
that's amazing.
As a champion, pushing forward.
I want to
play
that.
Yep, building a barracks, upgrading your troops, leading your troops into battle as you inspire them, and fighting an army. You are fighting an army of the opposite faction.
You know, one of the things I wanted to talk about, is Alex and I were discussing it a little bit earlier, was about the factions, about the dungeons. I'm sorry, about the factional dungeons.
Yeah.
Because we said that there were 10 dungeons, and there are 4 Horde and 4 Alliance. And as I started to think about it last night, I was like, have we ever really had factional dungeons? I mean, we've had Nomoran, we've had Burning Chasm, we've had Stockades, but you had to do like corpse runs and there were schlep to get to, even if it was like you couldn't get into it or dead mines or whatever.
Yeah.
So what was it like, can I get in, if I'm Horde, can I get into there or before 120 or like the way you could?
You likely technically could, but it would be kind of like trying to get to dead mines.
Same.
As a level 17 Horde player back in the day,
not
really advisable. And I think really it's anchored in the story we're trying to tell. The story begins with Alliance and Horde each searching out new allies, but as they do so, they learn about a lot of woes that are facing the world as a whole, and some deeper problems as well. And you know, we've anchored dungeons into the storylines of our zones, the same way as you saw in Legion, you would play through High Mountain and then go into Neltharion's lair to recover the hammer.
Yep.
Similarly, because the zones are faction heavy, it made sense for the dungeons and the level up experience to be that as well.
Yeah.
But of course, at max level, all the content is there for everybody. There's
fantastic.
And that'll help the world PvP, I would assume, at that point.
Oh, yeah. So we have an actual Twitter question, which is from Disney Girl, which is, can she acquire your autograph while she's here? Are you going to be doing any signings?
I'm not going to be at the signing table, unfortunately.
But you can be stopped anytime, anywhere.
Odds are good. So BlizzCon, it's a whirlwind. I'll be doing a lot of press throughout the day. Evenings, around the convention center, hotel lobbies. I just can't wait to meet as many fans as possible. That's the magic of BlizzCon.
That's why we're here.
Exactly.
Well, thank you so much, Ian Hatzakos.
My pleasure.
Good luck with the expansion.
Yes, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
All of it.